Action. You're on.
All right. Brazil nut, take one. Okay, guys. All this pot is Brazil nut. I'm going to pass you this. Pass it around. Try to guess how many nuts can be inside. Mm-hmm. And we can very well organize as little slices. So this fruit lasts about 12 months to get ready since flower to drop.
Let Paula try.
Okay, ladies first, ladies first.
Come on.
It grows like that. Okay, please. Oh. Oh, be careful, careful. Shake it, ladies. Get real, bud. The idea is to count the nuts, eh?
Slowly,
slowly. Hey.
You just paint a face out of it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
So guys, boom, boom. Uh-huh. Let's see how, let's count how many nuts, eh?
One.
17 nuts.
Wow. Well, I was off by 8. I said there would be 20.
A ninja.
Ninja Puerto Riqueño. Wow.
But you got it. This is the product of your work here. Let's see. Oh, look at that. Can you give me one, please?
What? Oh, yes, sure.
Thank you.
Problem.
Oh yeah, I like these.
Selenium. Yeah. Selenium. Mm. Bro, stay humble, but not muscles.
No, you did it.
Really good.
Mira, aquí está la
honey. These are tamarinds? Yeah. Tamarinds are squirrel-sized New World primates. The offspring are cared for by all adult members, which includes the male. Group members also feed the infants, allowing the infants to take food from them. The group sleeps huddled together, which occurs in vines or branches. The saddleback tamarin, seen here, forms mixed species associations with other tamarins. These mixed species associations may serve to assist in protecting from predators.
Captain Henry.
Hola,
Henry.
Hola.
And our chef, Hilaria.
Hilaria. Nice to meet you.
We have two chefs. One is on the campsite already.
Oh.
They were yesterday. Now she's going with us.
Excellent.
Yeah. This is our chef.
Okay, Hilaria.
Hilaria.
Ahí al medio, al medio. Ahí está bien. Listo. Ahora sí. Ahora sí está. Ahí está sacado.
Cabecita.
Sí, sí, por la por la especie, sí. La especie solo crece metro y medio. This is a really good size for the species. Grow 2.5 meter or 3 meter. This is the one.
Okay.
Good day, John.
We're stopping off here briefly. Those of us who want to do a little bit of hiking, the rest of them are continuing on to the camp. And here is our intrepid group.
Ready taking photos?
All right. Excellent.
Taking some video.
Ladas, ladas.
Toujours ladas.
Toujours ladas.
This is the research center. So these guys are researching macaws and other stuff here. They have different trails. We're gonna go walk a little bit to the research center place. So we're gonna ask a permission to walk around the trail, and then we're gonna start our walk. But of course, we're gonna start to look for wildlife right now. So whatever we see, we're gonna stop.
Spix's guan is a fruit-eating bird that is widespread and fairly common in Amazonia. Like other guans, it resembles a pheasant or a turkey. The pale-winged trumpeter, also known as the white-winged trumpeter, is a species of bird in the Sophiidae family. It is found in southwestern Amazon rainforests of Brazil, northern Bolivia, and eastern Peru. The reproductive behavior of the pale-winged trumpeter is the best known of all the trumpeter species. Groups of adults defend a territory together. Several males mate with a dominant female, the dominant male doing so most often. The dominant female lays an average of 3 eggs in a hole in a tree, where both males and females tend to the incubation. The young hatch and are covered with thick, dark, cryptically patterned down. Soon afterwards, they jump down to the ground and follow the adults. Their call is a loud staccato trumpeting.
That's how they get safe. On the other hand, the cappuccino monkey gets large canine teeth, so easy for them to crack hard fruit, and the leftover will be eaten by the cooler monkey.
What's right there? Come back. Right there, there.
This way, there.
No, I did not.
Yeah, it's right here, this little branch. I made a little hole of this termite nest, and as soon as I opened the hole and I put a stake in, and all the termites came out, and all these are soldiers, the reason why the first to come out to see what's going on outside. So, and anteater normally making a slash and put the tongue over there, and the anteater is only able to resist half minute with the tongue while all the termites come out and get stuck on the sticky tongue of the anteater before he eat it. So the reason why the anteater is not able to get the tongue more than a minute there or 2 or 5 minutes is because these termites, the soldier, they release a kind of a gas that is very toxic, very itchy for the anteater's tongue. So that's why they first want to come out. So that's why the anteater never finished the whole nest. He only eats some, but when he made once, of course, will take hundreds of termites with just one swallow.
Those are the same kind Amazon kingfisher. Wow, he made a good job.
Of the many different genera that are members of the true parrots, the family Cetacidae, 6 genera are classified as macaws: the Ara, Anodorhynchus, Cyanocitta, Primolius, Orthocetaca, and Diocetaca. Macaws are native to North America, but only in Mexico, Central America, South America, and formerly the Caribbean. Most species are associated with forests, especially rainforests, but others prefer woodland or savanna-like habitats. Proportionately larger beaks, long tails, and relatively bare, light-colored medial, meaning facial patch areas, distinguish macaws from other parrots. Sometimes the facial patch is smaller in some species and limited to a yellow patch around the eyes and a second patch near the base of the beak in the members of the genus Anodorhynchus. A macaw's facial feather pattern is as unique as a fingerprint. The largest macaws are the hyacinth, buffins, the great green, and green-winged macaws. While still relatively large, macaws of the genera Cyanospida, Orthocetaca, and Primolius are significantly smaller than the members of the Anodorhynchus and Ara. The smallest members of the family, the red-shouldered macaw, is no longer than some parakeets of the genus Aratinga. Macaws, like other parrots, toucans, and woodpeckers, are zygodactyl, having their first and fourth toes point backwards. Here in the Peruvian rainforest, we saw 3 species of large macaws: the scarlet, the red and green, and the blue and yellow macaw. Adult blue and yellow macaws attain lengths of 32 to 34 inches. Adult red and green macaws attain lengths of 35 to 38 inches.
Oh, my. Mm-hmm.
Occurring alongside the two species of macaws we observed were Amazon parrots, members of the genus Amazona. Here we see a picture of Amazon parrots in flight. There are about 30 species of Amazon parrots that occur throughout South America, Central America, portions of North America, and in the Caribbean islands as well. Every morning, the macaws, the Amazon parrot, and other members of the parrot family come to the famous clay lick, which you see as exposed sides of the former river. Here the parrots ingest some of this clay because it has a detoxification effect on some of the fruits that the parrots eat.
Nice colors, huh?
I don't want to take a picture, it's too far.
Fungus here.
What's this name?
This is a pit viper.
You see this big tree here, the first large tree? Mm-hmm. The first tallest tree here.
The parrot snake is a venomous pit viper species found in the Amazon region of South America. It reaches about 1 meter in length. The venom of this species is an important cause of snake bites throughout the entire Amazon region. Due to its arboreal nature, most bites are to the upper portions of the body, including the hands, arms, and face. Clinical features of bite wounds include bruising, profound coagulopathy, and spontaneous bleeding. Symptoms reported from various case histories include localized pain, swelling, bruising, bleeding of the gums, loss of consciousness, and erythema, bleeding from the fang punctures, shock, bleeding from the mouth, nose and eyes, nausea, and incoagulable blood. At least one death has been reported.
Spider-Man, the center here.
Probably a new bug for science, we never know because we have.
Here, our guide shows us an insect that he could not identify.
I've never seen this flat bug here. So no idea what is this.
Take a picture.
Very flat. Snake. We have about three kind of them. The other one just gives you bite, pain, that thing.
Viene de acá, lo vas a ver a la izquierda. Está un árbol, un tronco así de botón. Ahí no son elefantes.
This is what I've been waiting for. Turn around, face me.
As their name would suggest, vocal communication forms an important part of the social behavior of howler monkeys. Each species has an enlarged hyoid bone, which enables them to make their loud vocalization. Group males generally call at dawn and dusk, as well as interspersed times throughout the day. The main vocals consist of loud, deep, guttural growls or howls. Howler monkeys are widely considered to be the loudest land animal.
Great.
And here we see fresh, several hour old probably, male jaguar footprints.
And at least we got that.
Heading down the river, we at last spot a jaguar. We considered that this might have been the prize sighting on the whole safari, although the puma was probably about equal. The jaguar is a very large feline in the Panthera genus and is the only extant Panthera species native to the New World. The jaguar is the third largest feline after the tiger and the lion. The jaguar's present range extends from southwestern United States and Mexico across much of Central America and south to Paraguay and northern Argentina. Apart from a known and possibly breeding population in Arizona and the bootheel of New Mexico, the cat has largely been extirpated from the United States since the early 20th century. This spotted cat most closely resembles the leopard physically, although it is usually larger and of sturdier build, and its behavioral and habitat characteristics are closer to those of the tiger. While dense rainforest is its preferred habitat, the jaguar will range across a variety of forested and open terrains. It is strongly associated with the presence of water and is notable, along with the tiger, as a feline that enjoys swimming. The jaguar is largely a solitary, opportunistic, stalk and ambush predator at the top of the food chain. It is a keystone species, playing an important role in stabilizing ecosystems and regulating the populations of the animals it hunts. The jaguar has an exceptionally powerful bite, even relative to other big cats. This allows it to pierce the shells of armored reptiles and to employ an unusual killing method. It bites directly through the skull of prey between the ears to deliver a fatal bite to the brain.